Just for the sake of the children, that they can understand. Just try to explain the stories that we heard on the lessons that we heard from the Bible. The first one comes from the book of Genesis. And it's about Abraham talking to God. And Abraham was, his name was Abraham. God said his name will be changed to Abraham because he was going to be a government or an agreement with him. And the agreement was that he was going to have a son. He did not have a son then, but he was going to have a son. And that son was going to be the start of the beginning of a big nation. Some countries would be formed from the descendants of his son. Some kings and rulers would all come from the same blessing. And God said to him, you be true to me, I'll be true to you, and look after you. So that is the story from the Bible, that we know that Abraham was a father of faith, as some people believe him, because he trusted God, and he trusted God's ways. And whatever God told him to leave his home and his village and wherever, and go to where he was going to tell him to go. And so he did. And he was indeed blessed by his wife. He was very old when his wife got pregnant. Had his son Isaac, and then from there on, grew so many, many, many people. Beginning of the nation of Israel. The second story is what we read to us. It's about Jesus saying to his disciples, it doesn't really matter what you get or what you try in this life, as long as you save yourself. Don't lose your life in the things that you do. Doesn't make any sense, doesn't profit anymore if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul, which is gaining the world is really people thinking to have lots of money, lots of wealth, so that they can have everything. But in that process, Jesus says that we must be careful. We can have lots of money, lots of happiness, lots of freedom, lots of everything. And we end up losing our lives. Our lives being our souls and our hearts. We just become like everybody else. Nothing special about us. But if we try to stay true to ourselves and follow the way of Jesus, then we will find our soul or our lives. What it means. And so that is what I'm trying to preach about. So God bless you and continue to be with you in at school, at home, even in our church. You will continue to be a big part of our worship and our church life. So thank you, children, for coming to the church and for being in Sunday school. And also being at home and obeying and doing some work for your parents. God bless you and be with you.